Hi, welcome back. You're watching Checkpoint. Keep your feedback coming. We're still with Wanjiru Gikonyo and Senator Beatrice Silachi. Wanjiru, before we took the break, you were making a point about devolution.
Yes, I was challenging a point that the Senator made about comparing county governments with local authorities and asking, you know, why were local authorities able to deliver services yet county governments are not delivering as they're meant to be. And you cannot make that comparison because these are completely different entities. County governments are distinct government entities with a full administrative staff. But the truth of the matter is county governments have inherited a lot of unresolved liabilities. A lot of their assets were not audited, not transferred, because the process of doing that broke down, partly due to non-compliance by the national government. So the transition mechanism, also human resource, there were human resources supposed to be given to the county governments, that the whole process of handing all this over and realigning it was done terribly because the transition authority failed in its mandate. A lot of that had to do with frustration by the national government, underfunding and interference by the national government. So number one, county governments have inherited historical costs that are, you know, impacting their ability to deliver services, like Nairobi
but
County.
Nairobi County Society called out the county governments?
102% of the money that Nairobi County receives goes to salaries. Now, it's possible there's some ghost workers. Mm-hmm. We know there is corruption at the county governments. But you see, devolution was not set up so that we can fight corruption. It was set up so that we can have citizens say in service delivery. So that when you talk about devolved government, you have to remember there's the county aspect and there's the national aspect. And the national government has frustrated devolution, has prevented devolution from picking up as it should, and it's not true that so much resources are going to county governments. In fact, it's a matter of great concern that national government wage bill has increased by 40% since 2013. An audit report carried out by the National Assembly found that the biggest risk to the implementation of the Constitution and to the economy is national government's growth, because they are so expansionary, there's a lot of waste, a lot of largesse, and instead of rationalizing them, they're creating additional institutions. Further, national government is still implementing functions that county governments have been given.
Such as?
You have this big agriculture projects. You've got a lot of funds in the parastatals under agriculture. Agriculture is one of the big ones. You've got dispute now even over health, mm-hmm. reclassification of health facilities, so that the few referral hospitals that were supposed to stay with the national government, when they attempt to reclassify, they'll then get more of the health functions.
Okay.
You've got them doing managing control of illicit blues and all of that.
Uh-huh.
You've got the funds. You've got the CDFs. You've got, of course, an entire provincial administration structure. So what we have, we are actually supporting devolved government, national, uh-huh. county government, and national government has another arm duplicating the counties. So what Senator Alachi needs to help us understand is why the Senate has not done enough to rationalize and you know, give them credit. They have fought for enough resources to go to the counties.
Mm-hmm.
They tend to lose that debate because national government is very intransigent. But they are not calling out the fact that national government continues to grow as the functions are
at the expense of devolution
All and right. services to the people.
Okay, Senator, as you close, because you were talking about civil society calling out county governments, but then that is essentially the role of the Senate.
Well, it's the role of the Senate, and I believe the Senate has done its role. The functions were devolved. Those were initiative four have been devolved before TA left. Health is completely devolved, so it's not a function with the national government. How they do their equipment, it's through their own agreements where they sign both of them. The counties that have agreed will sign. The counties that have not agreed still cannot be forced to do what the national government wants them to do.
Right.
So that is something that is completely devolved. But it will also be very wrong for us to sit here and tell Kenyans that we do not want to look at the corruption that is done in counties vis-a-vis the corrupt. For me, let us look at corruption as corruption.
individualistic, whether it's at the county. In fact, it is very wrong for us to be talking about corruption at the county level because it was never a devolved function. And therefore, the things that the national government did, we thought in our minds as Kenyans, we will see a different thing at the counties. Nevertheless, the worst we did, we took the same members of the National Assembly who are the ones who did the constitution, are the ones who went, and most of them became governors.
All right, very quickly, because we have just about a minute. Kenyans still complain of the high cost of living, and so despite all of these great things that the Jubilee's government is doing in terms of the standard gauge railway, electricity, geothermal, but Kenyans are still feeling the pinch. I mean, you know, the cost of living has gone up, and so at the end of the day, the perception amongst the Kenyans is, my life hasn't gotten better. In fact, that recent poll, some 40% of Kenyans said they're living their worst life ever this year.
I will agree, and that is why you have a challenge when a country is in transition and when a country is more on a development agenda of big projects, because what the average Kenyan would wish to see is the small projects that are tangible, that touches lives daily. The projects that the Grand Coalition started, which now Jubilee came and inherited and took over and should make sure they are over because we had already spent taxpayers' money on them, are projects that will take a while before someone within the lower level will feel that tangible touch. We need to now ask ourselves as Jubilee, as we move on, I would want us to concentrate more on the agricultural sector, on the informal sector, on the entrepreneurship sector, where innovations, young people can come up with tangible innovations that can transform lives.
Okay.
Until we do that, the big projects will come in, they will safeguard Kenya, yes, but they will take a while for us to see the transformation of our lower level.
All right, I want to give you just a minute.
It's a matter of balance. Yeah. The Jubilee administration has focused on large infrastructure, a lot of corruption in the large infrastructure, which is very worrying because then it's a huge cost. But you can't tell citizens to wait for health. You can't tell them to wait for food, which is a devolved function. It's not supposed to be implemented by national government. So that is where the disconnect comes. And that's why I said the biggest problem the Jubilee administration has is ideological. They don't understand or accept the constitutional framework in which they work. Okay. And moving forward, next elections, we need to ask ourselves when we vote, are we voting for a pro-constitutional or anti-constitutional government and leader?
Okay, all right. Thank you very much, both of you. Wanjiru Gikonyo from the Institute for Social Accountability, Senator Beatrice Alachi. Thank you, ladies, for your time. I just want to give you the result of our poll today. We asked you how you would rate Jubilee's performance. So far, we gave you three options, good, bad, and average. 19% of you on Twitter said good, the performance of the Jubilee government is good. 59% said it is bad, and 22% said it is average. So quite a bit of work to be done, and we will wait to see how that goes. Thanks for your feedback. This is Checkpoint. We continue with more of our stories today.